Hello, and welcome to another Lawn Fawn video. Today we are introducing our brand new tote bag die. This die is so cool, so let's check it out. Here you can see the die, and you can see that there are some embossing lines in the die, and those create your fold lines for assembling the bag, which I'll show you soon. So I like to take a piece of cardstock that's 5 3/4 by about 11 inches. So I just cut my 8.5 by 11 cardstock down, and I'm able to get 2 tote bags out of this piece of cardstock. So I'm gonna put the first one through in my die cutting machine. I'll just run that through. And a lot of times I like to run it through twice just to make sure that those fold lines really do emboss well into the cardstock. So here is one piece. And then I'm gonna run it through again by just flipping it over and really using the most out of my cardstock that I can. So I'll just run that through the die cut machine, and I'll do 2 passes of that. And now I have my second tote bag piece, and it's gonna require 2 pieces to form the whole bag. So here you can see my 2 pieces are ready to go, and now it's time to fold along those score lines that the die did for you. So we're gonna fold along those 4 different lines. So I like to fold right along there, and then I like to take a bone folder and just crease that really well. The sharper these edges are, the better the bag is gonna look. Now I'll fold down that second score line and use my bone folder once again to crease it really well. And then I'm gonna fold down those 2 little tabs on the sides. And once again, I'm going to repeat folding those down really well with the bone folder. Those crisp edges really do make a difference. Now that I have one piece done, I'm going to repeat the same exact thing. So I'm going to score those same 4 lines and crease them really well with my bone folder. You'll see that there's some other lines there in the middle that are going to create the gusset for the bag, but you don't need to worry about those just yet. I'll show you a trick for those later. So only fold these score lines, and then we'll deal with those other little score lines in the middle of that tab piece later on. Now that I have my 2 pieces of the bag ready to go, I can take them both and form a T-shape with them, and this is how the bag is going to start to be put together. So now that I have my T-shape, I can start laying some adhesive down on that bottom part of the bag. So I'm just gonna lay down 3 pieces of some strong score tape adhesive, peel off the liner to expose the adhesive, and now I can layer those 2 together. I kind of like to bring the one up and then shove the other one in the corner, and that way they always line up perfectly. So I'm kind of using that corner edge to help my 2 pieces line up. And now I have the T-shape part of my bag. Next, it's time to form the bag by adding adhesive to all of those little tabs that we folded earlier. And once again, I love using this score tape because it's nice and strong and it's terrible too. So you can just kind of put it on there and rip it right off and make a lot of tote bags really quickly. So now that I have adhesive on all of these parts, I'm ready to actually form the bag. So now it's time to peel up all of those liner papers and start to actually form the bag, which is the most fun part. So I'm gonna take that piece and line it up with the outside edge of the front of the bag, and then use my fingers to adhere that tab to the inside of the bag. And then I'm gonna repeat that one more time. So you can see I'm lining it up with the outside part of the bag, and then I'm gonna push my finger inside to make sure that that's adhered really well. Now I can repeat the same thing for the back of the bag. So I'm just gonna adhere those 2 pieces together, push it down, and the last one's the easiest one since it's almost done, and I'll just line that up and once again give it a nice push there on the inside to make sure that it really has adhered well. Now it's time to deal with those score lines that we left alone earlier, these ones right there. You're going to take your fingers and you're going to push them into the bag, and then you're going to squeeze that bag shut, and it's going to fold them for you, so you don't even have to worry about them at all. It makes it so easy to do, and the bag looks so cute once you do this. It really does look like a really cute little tote shopping bag, and I am just in love with it. And now the other great thing about this cute little tote bag is that it fits a gift card. You could put candies in there or little presents or anything, but I love that it'll fit a gift card because it's such a great way to dress up presents. It's just adorable. So let's go ahead and start making some fun tote bags. Here I've cut a tote bag from one of the brand new perfectly plaid papers. These totes look so cool cut from the plaid papers. And I'm going to assemble the first part of the bag, the T-shaped part of the bag, but then stop there so that I can decorate it. The new Let's Polka in the Meadow colors coordinate so well with the perfectly plaid. So I'm going to take this grasshopper polka color, cut it down to 3.5 inches wide, which is the width of the bag, and cut it with the brand new Meadow Borders die. I just love this gorgeous tall grass. Now I'm going to take some stamps from Chirpy Chirp Chirp and stamp my sentiment on this grass panel. So I'm using some Noble Fur ink and I'm going to stamp Chirpy Chirp Chirp and then translation Happy Easter. Now that I've stamped it, I can trim this piece down right to the bottom of where the Happy Easter sentiment is. Then I'm going to adhere that right along the bottom part of the bag. And now I'm going to cut some tulips out of some guava cardstock using the tulip die that's included with the Meadow Borders. And I can start to adhere those on top of the grass pieces to make it look like a cute little flower meadow, gorgeous little area. Now here's my little Easter chick from Chirpy Chirp Chirp. I'm going to adhere him down with this cute little Easter basket. And now I can form the rest of the bag since everything is all decorated. So I'm going to peel up those layers and just form that bag, press in those side edges, and now I have an adorable little Easter bag that's so cute. It would look so cute with Easter grass and little Easter candies inside. I just love how it turned out. Next, I thought it would be fun to create a cute and simple birthday bag. So I'm using Make-A-Wish from Party Animal, and I'm going to mask off the wish part there with some post-it tape, ink up my stamp, peel off that post-it tape, and just stamp the make-a part. And then once I've done that, I'm going to do the same thing with wish. So I'm going to take post-it note tape, cover make-a, and stamp the wish out. Now I'm going to take a frame from Flirty Frames and stamp that right over and color it in really simply with just one Copic marker. This is the Bougainvillea R43 color. I'll use my die to cut out that shape. And now I've created a bag with some Nadia paper from Perfectly Plaid, and I am just going to tape that with foam tape right onto the bag. Now this was inspired by some bags that Nicole made that I just loved, and I thought it would be fun to create a little birthday version of them. I'm adding some glitter because every birthday needs a little glitter, and then some pink lemonade lawn trimmings to the top, and I just love how this turned out. It's super quick and easy. You could pop a gift card there and give someone a really sweet present that they would just love. And now here is a look at the two bags together. There are so many possibilities with this bag, especially going out into Christmas too. There's going to be such cute things that you can do with them. So this is the brand new tote bag die. I love this die so much. You can make cute, simple bags like this one or more complicated stamp scenes on them like this. It fits a gift card, which is so awesome. And you can really get so creative with this die. And I cannot wait to see what you guys create with it because I know it's going to be so awesome. So thank you guys so much for watching. And I hope you have an absolutely amazing day. Bye.